everyone. In this video, we will cover the current affairs. Before we move ahead, let me inform you that these questions are part of our daily 20 MCQ series in GK Today's Academy Android application. So if you are looking for the text version of these questions and their explanations along with the interactive quiz, you may consider joining our daily 20 MCQ series in Academy Android application. So in this app course, you get daily 20 MCQs, a fortnightly quiz, a monthly revision document, and also category-wise revision ebooks, which are optimized for reading on your mobile itself. Apart from it, you are also able to access all archives of questions from January 2020 onwards. Please check our Telegram channel. The link is given in the description box. You can subscribe to it if you find it relevant. For hard copy books, you can visit our website gktbooks.com. Okay, so now without wasting any further time, let's get started. Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to GK Today. And today we'll be discussing most important MCQs for 12th of November 2021. Starting with very first question, which Indian bank launched the first video life certificate service for pensioners? So the State Bank of India has launched the first video life certificate service for the pensioners, and this new facility will allow the pensioners to submit their life certificates through video from their homes. And as per the SBI, this facility is available for only pensioners, and spouse of the pensioner who is receiving a pension will not be able to use this facility. And the process of video life certificate is totally paperless and also available free of cost. Okay. Now apart from it, the Reserve Bank of India has recently published its statement of commitment to support Greening India's financial system, that is NGFS. And RBI joined the Central Banks and Supervisors Network for Greening the Financial System as a member on 23rd of April 2021. And on the occasion of 2021 United Nations Climate Change Conference, that is COP26, NGFS agreed to contribute to meet the objectives of Paris Agreement. Now apart from it, RBI has come out with a revised prompt corrective action framework for scheduled commercial banks, which would come into effect from 1st of January 2022. And it has stated that RBI would monitor three key areas: capital, asset quality, and leverage for the banks, and breach of threshold in any one parameter would invoke PCA. Okay? Now, a few days back, we have seen that recently RBI has imposed a monetary penalty of 1 crore rupees on Paytm Payments Bank, and the penalty was for submitting the information that did not reflect the factual position. Okay, and now you have to tell me, the RBI has also imposed a penalty of 27.78 lakh rupees on which organization for non-compliance with MTSS directions, that is Money Transfer Service Scheme directions. Please write your answers in the comment section. Question number 2. As per a recent NASA study on climate change, which crop is set to see a growth of 17% due to climate change? So according to new NASA study published in the journal Nature Food, climate change may affect the production of maize and wheat by 2030 under a high greenhouse gas emissions scenario. So as per this study, maize crop yields are projected to decline by 24%, while wheat could potentially see a growth of about 17%. And this is due to increases in temperature, shift in rainfall patterns, and elevated surface carbon dioxide concentrations from greenhouse gas emissions. Okay. Now apart from it, independent researchers from India have conceptualized and developed an online dashboard named as Climate Equity Monitor on global climate policy. So this dashboard basically provides an online portal for accessing equity in climate action, then inequalities in emissions, energy consumption across the world, and reviewing climate policies of several countries. So basically it aims to monitor the performance of Annex 1 parties under the UNFCCC. Okay, you have to tell me, what does this term stands for? Please write your answers in the comment section. Also, in COP26 summit, all the world leaders promised to end and reverse deforestation by the year 2030. Also, in the previous lecture, I have told you that a glacier in Antarctica has been formally named as Glasgow Glacier in honor of the city hosting the United Nations Climate Summit to mark this COP26. Okay? And apart from all these things, Prime Minister of India Narendra Modi has launched IRIS, which stands for Initiative for the Resilient Island States for Developing Infrastructure of Small Island Nations. And also Prime Minister said that ISRO will build a special data window for them to provide information about floods, cyclones, coral reef monitoring, coastline monitoring, etc. through satellites. Fine. Question number 3. Which country is the first in the world to approve an oral pill named as Molnupiravir to treat symptomatic COVID? So UK Medicines Regulator has recently approved the first antiviral pill designed to treat symptomatic COVID. And this tablet will be given twice a day to vulnerable patients recently diagnosed with the COVID-19. And the pill, which was originally developed to treat flu, is claimed to cut the risk of hospitalization or death by about 50%. Now, apart from it, a new research funded by Cancer Research UK has recently found that HPV vaccine reduced the risk of developing the cancer by 62% in women between the ages of 14 and 16. So this vaccine is administered to protect against cervical cancer in women, and as per a research, it reduced the risk by 34% in women who were aged 16 to 18 years when they were offered the jab. Okay. Now apart from it, UK will provide an India Green guarantee to the World Bank to unlock £750 million for green projects across India. And this was also announced at the COP26 in Glasgow. Also, UK committed over £210 million at the UN Climate Summit under PIDG, that is Private Infrastructure Development Group. And the Green Guarantee financing will support clean and resilient infrastructure in sectors including clean energy, transport, and urban development. Now, apart from it, small island nation of Tonga has recently confirmed its very first case of COVID-19 after a long time. Okay. Question number 4. Which Indian state has set up first ever SPV to manage 3 critical natural conservation missions? So Tamil Nadu has set up first ever special purpose vehicle named as Tamil Nadu Green Climate Company to professionally manage 3 critical natural conservation missions. And the company will manage the Tamil Nadu Climate Change, Tamil Nadu Green and Tamil Nadu Wetland Missions. And the SPV's authorized capital will be 5 crore and the State Environment Secretary will be the company's chairperson and MD. Okay. Now apart from it, Bestu Varas or Gujarati New Year is celebrated in Kartik month of Hindu calendar, and the day is traditionally known as Varsha Pratipada, and people celebrate this day by preparing new books to keep accounts called the Chopra. Also, they worship Goddess Lakshmi and Lord Krishna on this day. Now, apart from it, India and Bhutan will have 7 additional entry and exit points for trade as part of measures to increase trade connectivity. So these include Nagarkatta Land Custom Station, Agartala Land Custom Station, Pandu Port or Guwahati Steamer Ghat. Fourth is Jogi Ghopa Port. Then Asian Highway 48 connecting Tosha Tea Garden in India and LA in Bhutan, among others. Okay. And trade between India and Bhutan rose from $484 million in 2014-15 to $1,083 million in 2022-21. Okay. Question number 5. Which country has announced $18 billion stimulus plan to fund households with children? So Japan has announced a stimulus plan under which the country will spend roughly 2 trillion yen, or you can say $18 billion, on cash payments to the households with children under the age of 18 years. So this is a part of an economic stimulus plan aimed to tackle the impact of COVID-19 pandemic. And under this plan, households will be entitled to receive 1 lakh yen per child regardless of household income. Now last month we have seen that recently India and Japan held their 6th Maritime Affairs Dialogue in virtual format, and the consultations involved exchanges on development in the maritime security environment, regional cooperation activities, and opportunity for cooperation between the two countries in the Indo-Pacific region. Also, new Prime Minister of Japan is Fumio Kishida, and he has replaced Yoshihide Suga. Also important thing is Mr. Rajneesh Kumar, who is the former chairman of SBI, has been appointed as chairman of BharatPay now. Then Mr. Anil Bhatt has recently been appointed as Director General of Indian Space Association, and Vice Admiral Adhir Arora has taken charge as Chief Hydrographer to the Government of India, and he has replaced Vinay Badwar. Okay. Question number 6. Which state has approved the Industrial Relations Rules 2021? So the Assam Cabinet approved the Industrial Relations Rules 2021, which aims to safeguard the right of employers and employees both. And the Cabinet has approved a scheme for providing ration to the migrant workers who faced hardship during this COVID-19 pandemic. And the rules have been framed with a view to simplify and rationalize the provisions of 3 central labor codes relating to the industrial relations. Now apart from it, recently IUCN has alerted the Assam government on the threats faced by Bengal Florican, and as per the IUCN, developing activities and state government's plan to set up a university at Kogilabari Seed Farm near Manas National Park in Assam has posed a threat to the Bengal Florican. Also recently, NABARD has entered into an agreement with Assam for facilitation of 13,200 crore rupees infrastructure project in the state for a period of 3 years. Also a few days back, the Assam Fisheries Ministry has launched an application which is the India's first e-fish market app named as Fishwale. And now this application will help both buyers and sellers to place orders and sell fishes online. Question number 7. Which tech giant services would no longer be accessible from China from November 1, 2021? So tech major Yahoo has proposed to pull out its operations from China following China's personal information protection law coming into effect from 1st of November. So it has stated that company services would no longer be accessible from China from 1st of November, and it is stated that Yahoo has made this decision on the grounds that China's business environment is increasingly challenging now. Okay, now already we have seen that Meta is a new name of Facebook, and China has recently launched a rocket named as Shijian-21 atop of Long March 3B rocket from Zhejiang Satellite Launch Center. Also, Indian Army has recently deployed Pinaka and Smarch multiple rocket launcher systems near the China border to counter any threat across LAC. And Pinaka weapon system is an autonomous rocket artillery system, while Smarch system is the longest range conventional rocket system. Okay? Now you have to tell me which country has recently launched its first ever homegrown rocket named as Nuri. Please write your answers in the comment section. Question number 8. Which ministry has proposed to launch a national drone technology conference in India? So the Union Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology has proposed to host a national level drone technology conference in India, and the ministry has stated that it would be an annual event which would create a platform for users and technology providers. So recently the government of India has released new drone rules 2021, which permits for higher payloads. Also, it increases the coverage of drones from 300 kgs to 500 kg and include rules for drone taxis. Okay. Now, apart from it, the Union Ministry of Rural Development has entered into an MOU with e-commerce company Flipkart under the Deen Dayal Antyodaya Yojana National Rural Livelihood Missions. And this partnership aims to sell products made by artisans, self-help groups and women under this Yojana in Flipkart platform. So hence this will create a national level market for these products. Now in the previous lecture we have seen that a 20 member empowered group of secretaries has been constituted by the Government of India to monitor the development and implementation of Pradhan Mantri Gati Shakti National Master Plan. And also we have seen that an integrated single window filming mechanism has been created by Ministry of Railway and Ministry of Information and Broadcasting. And the objective of this scheme is to make the permission for filming across railway's premises easier and more efficient. Okay. Question number 9. Jai Bhim Mukhya Mantri Pratibha Vikas Yojana 2021 is launched by which state or union territory? So the government of Delhi has launched this Yojana for the benefit of students belonging to the scheduled corps, scheduled caste, scheduled tribe and backward class. And under the scheme, free coaching classes for needy students who are preparing for UPSC, CDS, NEET, JEE mains examinations, etc. would be provided. Now earlier we have seen that New Delhi has launched a patrolling operation named as Operation Satark to combat and prevent crime and make public places more safe. So the Southwest District Police has launched this patrolling operation where the senior officials including women officers will be patrolling on foot, and this is aimed to enable a thorough check on noise creators and provide confidence among the public. Now also Delhi has recently launched Desh Ke Mentor program to provide career guidance to the students of class 9 to 12, and hence the students will be mentored by subject experts for providing various career options. So every mentor will adopt up to 10 students to provide career counseling, and actor Sonu Sood has been named by Delhi government as the brand ambassador of this particular initiative. Okay. Now can you tell me who is the brand ambassador of Adidas Stay and Play campaign? Please write your answers in the comments. Coming to last question, when is World Tsunami Awareness Day observed every year? So World Tsunami Awareness Day is observed every year on 5th of November by the United Nations to spread awareness about this disaster. So in the year 2015, United Nations General Assembly passed a resolution in this regard, and as per a UN report, tsunami in Indian Ocean in the year 2004 has been recorded as the most hazardous natural disaster which occurred in the past 100 years. Okay. Now also every year United Nations observes 2nd of November as International Day to End Impunity for Crimes Against Journalists, so as to highlight the instrumental role played by the journalist in investigating and prosecuting. So as per the UN report, over 1200 journalists have been killed between 2006 and 2020 for reporting the news and bringing information to the public. Okay. Now apart from all these things, four members, namely Government of UK, Italian State Lender, European Union and Green Climate Fund, have collectively pledged a sum of $665 million towards a platform to be managed by Asian Development Bank, and this funding aims to finance climate change related projects in the Southeast Asian region. And this announcement was made at the COP26 Glasgow Summit. Okay. Now let's start with today's quiz. Here on the slide you can see 5 questions which have been taken from the past 2-3 days current affairs. Pause the video and try to solve each of these questions. And at the end of the lecture, do not forget to share your scores in the comment section. So please be honest and do not cheat with yourself. So that's it for today. I hope you have liked the session. These were the important news and events from today. And we will meet again tomorrow with some more important current affairs. Till then, stay tuned. Thank you so much for watching. And please do not forget to subscribe to GK Today. With this, Meenu Zarsana signing off.